Good evening, everyone. Welcome to today's podcast. It is 19th March 2020, and let's start with it. So today's topic, we are going to discuss the market review, and I'm going to discuss exchange-traded funds today. So we are going to discuss what are exchange-traded funds and which funds I'm currently looking at. So market review, and before we start, let's get on with the disclaimer. This podcast is only for education purpose. It is not in any way to be considered as investment advice. If you want investment advice, connect with an investment advisor or study these companies on your own before taking an educated call. So market review, markets were relatively flat after this huge move in last and this week. So S&P 500 was 0.47% up, Dow Jones was 0.85% up, NASDAQ 2.3% up, TSX 3.83% up. So let's start with today's topic. So before we go into exchange traded funds, I want to discuss the concept of core portfolio and thematic portfolio. Now, what is your core portfolio? Core portfolio should always consist of diversified holdings. Diversified means you're not exposed to a particular sector or a particular stock. More or less, your risk is divided, or you're not putting all your eggs in one basket. Your risk is divided into multiple stocks. The best way to create core portfolio is through broad ETFs. So you can look at an ETF of SAP 500. So what is SAP 500? It's an index in United States that has broad exposure to all industries, and it generally consists of 500 big American companies. I do not invest in small cap and mid cap indexes in my core portfolio. The reason I don't do that is small cap and mid cap are exposed when the recession happens. Whenever recession happens, small and mid cap companies generally close faster than the large cap companies. So I do not want to expose myself to that risk. Once again, like I have always told you, I'm a very risk averse investor. So I do not take much risk on my core portfolio. Generally, I go with SAP 500 because it is broadly diversified. Now, once you have your core portfolio sorted out, next thing you can consider is the thematic portfolio. This is where you take risk. Now, how do I divide my entire portfolio? 60 to 70% of all my money is in the core portfolio. 40 to 30% is what I play with. So within this 40 to 30%, I have my stocks, I have my thematic ETFs and all that thing. So thematic portfolio is 30 to 40% what you play with. Now, the themes that I'm currently looking at is NASDAQ composite. So I'm generally, NASDAQ composite is an index that follows the broad tech sector. And as all of you know, I'm a big time believer in tech. So I'm always bullish on tech. So major theme that I'm looking at is after this recession ends, whenever it ends, 2 years, 6 months, 2 months, we don't know. But whenever it ends, lot of tech companies are going to survive because tech companies don't take much debt. They are not capital intensive and they are not really impacted. I mean, especially software as a service is not really impacted by supply chains. So that is what my general theme is. So that's why I'm bullish on NASDAQ composite. Then I'm looking at gaming sector. The second theme I'm looking at, people are staying at home. They're going to play a lot of games. And sports is closed. So esports is also a category in gaming. So esports is where you have sports competitions in games like World of Warcraft or many other games. So it's like sports plus gaming. So it's a competitive gaming structure. And you would not believe more than 500 million people across the world follow it. So gaming is a theme that I'm bullish on. So I'm also building up my positions in gaming ETFs. Then the next theme I'm bullish on is 3D printing. I believe that manufacturing is coming back to North America. We had a lot of issues with supply chain. There was a wage arbitrage. So wage arbitrage is narrowing. That's why manufacturing is, I think, going to move back to North America. And when the manufacturing moves back, it will focus more on 3D printing because it's localized low volume printing that means it 3D printing enables us to do that. So I'm a little bit bullish on 3D printing, and I'm also bullish on AI and robotics because artificial intelligence is leading the fourth revolution that we have. And everything like 5G, artificial intelligence, then chip manufacturing, Moore's law, everything is concurring right now. So we are going to see a huge jump in AI adoption. That's why I'm bullish on artificial intelligence and robotics as a sector too. So once again, core portfolio, a diversified one. Thematic portfolio is where you take risk. The sectors that we are looking at, tech in general, gaming, 3D printing, and artificial intelligence and robotics in particular. So how do you take exposure to these sectors? So a good way to do that is exchange-traded funds. So what are exchange-traded funds? These are like mutual funds. You give your money to a fund manager, and then fund manager makes investments. What's different between a mutual fund and an exchange traded fund? The major difference, exchange traded funds have low cost, low fund management cost. So they have cost below 1%. So that's really good. Second, they passively follow an index. So they are not active. They don't make investment decision. They just follow a particular index. Third, and the most important one, they're liquid because they are traded on exchanges. So they're like mutual fund, low cost, passive funds, and exchange traded funds are good to build your core portfolio as well as to take thematic exposures. So the first ETF that we are going to talk today is SPDR, SAP 500 ETF Trust. The ticker symbol for that is SPY, and this ETF invest in SAP 500 companies. So it gives you exposure to SAP 500. The dividend yield is around 2%. It has seen a massive drop of 28%. I already hold a lot of ETFs that follow SAP 500, but this particular ETF, I have a price of around 226 or 227. So 227 is a major support. If it goes below 227, I would start buying. I have bought some when it was around 230, but I would again start buying when it goes below 226. Now, whenever you invest in SAP 500, you should always look at PE ratios. PE ratios, like we have discussed in last class too, it tells you whether the company is expensive, whether the ETF is expensive, or whether it is cheap. Now, when you look at SAP 500, I target a PE ratio of 15 and below if I can. It has not been 15 and below for a long while, but with this recession we may get there. Current PE ratio is 18.13. Anything below 20, you are good to go. So it's a good time to buy ETFs when the PE ratio is below 20, and you need to wait for 5 to 10 years to realize massive gains. But if it goes below 15, that is when I would start major buying into ETFs. So once again, PE ratios are important. Our philosophy is always buying good companies or buying good ETFs at the right price. If you buy a good company when it is extremely high, you're not going to make much money. But when you buy a good company when it is trading at a low price, that's when you start making money. So this also with ETFs, ETF that you look out is below 20, start buying little by little. But if it goes below 15, that is when you give a major push. Next ETF that we are going to talk about is a tech sector broad ETF. So the name is Fidelity NASDAQ Composite Index ETF. The ticker symbol is ONE1Q. Dividend yield of NASDAQ, this ETF is around 1%. Tech never pays much dividend, so it tries to reinvest all its money. That's why the dividend yield is low. It has seen a drop of around 26% since the top. And the price that I'm looking at is around 250. The current trading price for this ETF is 280. I'm looking to get into this because I already hold a lot of NASDAQ ETFs. I'm looking to average it out, average my holdings when this drops to 253. It has a major support, long-term support at 253. And PE ratios again, current PE for Nasdaq is 19.1. Again, our philosophy, anything below 20, you're good to buy. Because 20 and below, it's a reasonable price. Anything above 20, hold your money. Right? Right now, it is 19.1. Once again, the target for me to major push into the market is around 15. Next one is a riskier trade that I recently got into. I'm a big believer in gaming. I've always been, and the sector is booming. So the users, the games, the downloads, all data that you see, it's amazing. There are more than billion people in the world who play games right now. And it's not young people. The majority of gaming is women. Majority of gaming is men, means middle-aged men that are getting into gaming now. And especially this esports segment. Esports is followed by over 500 million people today. Around 500 million people are into esports. So that's a huge market. That's more than all the sports leagues that are there, like NBA or NFL. They're more than that. So that's why I'm bullish on the gaming. This is a good ETF that you can look into. The name is Van Eck Vector Video Gaming and Esports ETF. The ticker symbol is ESPO. The current price is around 34. The price that I am looking to get into is below 32. So 32 is the long term support for this ETF. Anything below 32 is when I would start getting into this ETF. Once again, it's a long term play, 5 year plus. So you know me, I do not invest, do not trade much in short run. I do trade sometimes, but majority of my talks are going to be about long run investments, making money in the long run, not in the short run. The next thing I'm also looking at is 3D printing. The thematic I am again discussing, manufacturing, I hope, is coming back after the supply chain issues we had. The wage arbitrage, the wage rates in the developing part of the world were cheap. Wage rates in the developed part of the world were high. That's why the manufacturing went abroad. But that wage gap is bridging. China is growing, the wages there are growing. Plus, energy is cheap in the developed part, means like in North America, it is cheaper than China. So if you are automating jobs, it's better to automate jobs in the developed world because the energy costs are low. You just need energy, you don't need people, right? And in the developing world, the energy costs are high. So the long run theme, it may take decade to really realize money out of it. But long run theme is that manufacturing may come back and it could potentially be a big money generator. So I'm looking at 3D printing ETF. The name is the 3D printing ETF by ARK Investments. Ticker symbol PRNT, print. It is 31% down from its top. It has a wavered ride. It went up, went down, went up, went down. I'm looking to enter at a price of 15. Right now, I think it's around 16. And the last one, the last theme that we are going to talk, artificial intelligence and robotics. AI is a big game changer. Robotics is a big game changer. Internet of Things is going to come because of 5G. You are going to get into those smart homes and robots and all of that. I personally own a lot of robots around me. I have a Roomba that cleans it. I have a robo mopper. And more people are going to adopt consumer robots as well as industrial robots. So 10 plus year decade theme that I am looking at is robotics. So this is an ETF like Global X Robotics and Artificial Intelligence ETF. The ticker symbol is BOTS, BOTZ. It is over 30% down. Price I am looking at is 15 and below to get into this fund. So once again, we discussed a lot of things, important stuff. Create your core portfolio by diversified holding. Then you can take exposures into individual stocks, or you can take exposure to specific industries and specific themes.